they can easily just walk in and take that turtle, which in fact has already been attempted. And well, since they're going to be able to actually secure that. And now here comes LJ. He's looking for that Tyrant's Rage. Not going to be landing though. That's going to be Red House Tree kicking him back to the team. This might just be it. But the rest of RRQ has to run to the scene. EVOS now running for their life. Red Master escape. But how long can they take this on? As we will see. But John getting pulled right into it. The trap. It's a mega kill coming in for Sid.
That was so huge for RRQ. And now EVOS on the back foot as RRQ are going to break into the 30k mark. They're trying to look to crush all the way to the end here. The 11 minute mark has been hit. They don't have the Luminous Lord. Unfortunately, the Death Sonata comes out very early on. Juan's in trouble. He's right on top of the bouncing ball. LJ is able to walk up on top of him and get him with the bouncing ball as EVOS Legends are in a lot of trouble as they lose another inhibitor target. Luminaris chunked till pretty low, and now they have to make their way out of there, but they just can't. As the last goes down, Rek trying to save this situation. It's not looking good at all. Rek as well having to flicker forward, and LJ, he is still alive despite all that damage. Game one going to RRQ. This is what they should have been doing yesterday, is EVOS want to punish this Leo mode before he reaches critical mass. And although Cho might be a little bit of a problem, at least you're not going to have to worry about the playmaking capability. Oh, yes. Juan, he's already got quite a bit of damage into LJ. He's forced to walk back, walk out of his revitalized. What? But John secures a double kill. The base damage is still there. EVOS still got what it takes to win this game. Leomord, instead of going for high and dry, he wants to be able to get more items fast at a faster rate. However, he needs to be part of these fights. So that's why Uranus being annoying is very, very beneficial here. As Sid, he comes on through. He wants to pick up Rek one more time. Can Rek actually pull through as the Death Sonata? Sid did not miss this time. But on the top side, they've already turned this around. The wall charge, LJ trying to get on out of there. It isn't enough, but Lemon, with all the damage that he has, is getting chucked out by Juan, who's a little too big for these shoes. Here, Rexy got hit pretty hard. However, the secure strip isn't there. Juan, he needs one more auto attack. He actually does it. And the flicker coming through. He goes into the Winter Trudger Point. Lemon doesn't actually have his Phantom Steam, but he's trying his very best. The momentum wasn't enough to kill him. Not enough. Again! Oh my god! Rexy literally just saved this entire fight with a time journey from downtown!
And he actually gets to action recall! And now the Cho will be able to actually buy a little bit of time. But is it gonna be enough though? Four members now knocking at the door. It's gonna be the time journey, and they are gonna knock him away. They are only
gonna win it!
And they do it! And it will be a draw!
Rekt, again, is going to be the fourth Iron Fortress of that top lane. Zin's in trouble. He takes two hits of the Feathered Airstrike, and that already puts him down to 30% of his HP. Rekt is dealing with R7 very, very well. Tarizla forced to go down to the bot side. I think it's a little bit of a mistake. He should have let Tarizla stay on the top side. But LJ is the next. He dodges the flame shot here. Everybody misses all their abilities. Rexy is going to be there to secure the kill. The Blazing Duet clears the waves, but it doesn't secure any kills. Rexy turns on top of Zin. Veen is able to heal up Sid enough and give him enough movement speed to secure another kill. Backline R7, this is complete madness. It's a monkey fiesta. Everyone is playing for KDA at this point.
They are just going on a brawl mode, and everyone is just fighting each other all around the map and diving onto Luminaire as well. RRQ, they are actually turning things around, but Rek is like, hey, hey.
There. Barca was just a little slow to get the Feather Airstrike down.
Yeah,
you know?
Just a split second late, if I'm saying. No, Vin! He finishes off, but straight to his face of Rexy as well. And now they are stuck in the wall in the hard place. That's gonna be that way of the dragon to actually secure the kill. Sin, now looking for a little bit pickup there. Yes, he dives all the way back. It's Luminaire!
Oh no, LJ is trying to pick up this kill. He does initially, and lands the stun as well. The flame shot coming in strong. And good job by Lemon here, pushing out the backline. He literally walked past all the frontliners. It's like, no, I'm too tanky. You gotta worry about me. Just trying his best to absorb these waves. As soon as they come in, he gets stunned. He's buying a little bit more time. Everybody else still has about 10 more seconds, plus 15 seconds to actually come back. Rexy gets a call. They might be able to hold on. Rexy, he's doing his job. He actually dodged the penalty zone. Pops the smoke as quickly as possible. Wrecked, they actually clear the wave. They bought themselves a more time as the respawns should be coming out now. But can they finish this game? RRQ is trying. One. Farsa clears the wave.
And there's only two more members left for EVOS Legends, and RRQ will be able to find that lead as they may be able to demolish members of EVOS right here. And they have found the opening, but one more challenge will be in the way. It's only up to Badan, but this is the support that can't really do all too much as he will fall.
A lot of it has to come down to one big team fight. Both sides are very team fight oriented, so expect the 5v5 to come out very, very soon. Farsa has to be careful of her positioning. He's all the way back in the base. Sid actually goes down too quick. This is it. This is the moment they've been waiting for. EVOS Legends, they're using the ultimates very aggressively. The back line is now down. Rixie coming with a Star Moon fall. LJ, the next on the chopping block. Now R7, he can't do anything more. He gets run down. Joe is gone. The crystal is broken on one Lord push. EVOS bring it 2-2. Wait a minute, they didn't give... Oh, it looks like they didn't give Rexy the blue buff this time, so he has to be very conservative of his mana here. But Vin, takes away the red buff. Juan is forced to back away. They're going to use Illuminaire to secure this kill here. But R7 is trying to pick him up. Oh, the maximum impact from the middle lane. And Sin did not miss when it mattered. They sacrificed two members to ensure that Juan is put behind.
Yep, they're putting in a lot of... Oh, the Abyssal Arrow lands, and now Juan is in a lot of trouble. Forced to flick around again,
and this time they secure everybody. They push them under the turret. RRQ with a hunger never seen before. Want to put EVOS in the dirt.
If EVOS have any chance of winning this game, the only way they win is if RRQ really mess up here.
Oh, here comes a maximum charger. Of course, they are going in for a little dive, as that will be the Lord slowly marching forward. But Esmeralda dives right in, looks for Cecilia, and this one erupts as they break up in the mid lane. But here comes Luminate, gets popped up and deleted. Mega kill going in as we see Batal, the next one to full. Double kill going for the Kimmy, and one will be slain.
It's over!
It's a Maniac! And here are your champions for Season 5 of the MPL Indonesia, RRQ Hoshi.
They've done it! Viva RRQ!